Good morning and good evening, everyone. Welcome to Cango Inc.'s second quarter 2021 earnings conference call. At this time, all participants are in a listen-only mode. This call is also being broadcast live on the company's IR website. Joining us today are Mr. Jiayuan Lin, Chief Executive Officer, and Mr. Michael Zhang, Chief Financial Officer of the company. Following management's prepared remarks, we will conduct the Q&A session. Before we begin, I refer you to the safe harbor statement in the company's earnings release, which also applies to the conference call today, as management will make forward-looking statements. With that said, I'm now turning the call over to Mr. Jiayuan Lin, CEO of Cango. Mr. Lin, the floor is yours, sir.
Good
morning and good evening, everyone. Welcome to Cango's 2021 Q2 earnings call. In the first half of 2021, China's auto market, still recovering from the impact of the COVID-19 pandemic, faced renewed pressure due to the persistent global chip shortage. In the wake of this shortage, OEMs have had to slow down production, and dealers have slashed promotions, leading to a significant decline in car production and sales. The volatility in the automotive market stemming from uneven chip supplies is unlikely to ease in the short term and is widely expected to linger in the second half of 2021. Meanwhile, price increases in other key components and raw materials have further intensified cost pressure on OEMs and fueled uncertainty in their production plans. The chip shortage crisis will undoubtedly slow the recovery of the auto industry. Despite this, Cango's overall business remained stable in the second quarter. Total revenues came in at 947 million RMB. Thanks to investment gains from Li Auto, we realized a net income of 558 million RMB.
我想先谈一下汽车交易服务业务。作为我们构建汽车交易服务平台的核心业务板块，车交易服务业务在第二季度的收入总额达到5.23亿元人民币，占比总收入近55.2%，逐渐成为支撑集团未来发展的重要引擎。汽车经销商作为流通终 端， 是汽车流通价值链中的关键一 环， 也是我们汽车交易服务的重要着力点。通过整合的车源、金融、保险以及其他车后服 务， 灿谷更好地赋能车 商， 进而提升整个产业的效率。对消费者而 言， 这也意味着购车流程更简单快 捷， 配套服务更丰富安 全， 用户体验得到提升。
Now I'd like to talk about our car trading transactions business. As the business at the core of our car transaction service platform, revenues from car trading transactions reached 523 million RMB in the second quarter, accounting for about 55.2% of the total revenues, signaling its gradual evolution into an important growth driver for our growth. Car dealers are not only just a key link in the auto transaction value chain, but also an important focus of our car trading transaction services. By integrating car sourcing, financing, insurance, and other aftermarket services, Cango empowers dealers and improves efficiency of the industry as a whole. For consumers, purchasing cars will be much simpler and faster, with more diversified and reliable supporting services, as well as enhanced user experience.
今年5月底，灿谷推出了面向经销商的 B2B 服务平台——灿谷好车。灿谷好车全方位整合汽车信息与交易， 物流、金融、保险等能力，直击下沉市场车商在业务过程中的痛点。灿谷深耕车、金融、保险领域十余载，搭建起覆盖全国升值低线级市场的渠道网络，连接超过47000家实体经销商。通过灿谷好车的切入，汽车交易领域是公司现有业务的自然延伸。我们将通过全方位多样化的产品和服务，进一步提高经销商粘性，真正做到为我们网络中的数万经销商赋能。
At the end of May 2021, we launched Kango 好车, a B2B service platform for dealers. Kango 好车 integrates information with transactions, logistics, finance, and insurance to directly address the unmet needs of car dealers in the lower tier markets. Thanks to more than 10 years of commitment, Kango has built up strong expertise in car financing and insurance services and a nationwide dealership network that covers over 40,000 dealers.Kango 好车 is a natural extension into the automotive transactions field. We aim to offer diversified and comprehensive products to further strengthen the bond between Kango and our dealers, as well as to empower our dealers.
与此同时，围绕车交易服务平台的基础能力建设持续加码。首先，在获客及客户服务端，作为我们重要导流工具的经纪人模式，在第二季度继续沿着既定方向扩展。目前已拥有超过13500名注册经纪人，并为其配置了581个支点经销商，进一步构建灿谷自身的私域流量。值得一提的是，本季度我们推出全新升级的灿谷车生活服务号，面向消费者提供涵盖购车、用车、养车的一站式服务。通过灿谷好车和灿谷车生活双平台，灿谷赋能 B 端商户，服务 C 端车主。此外，在供应链运营能力的建设上，截至二季度末，我们已与基础设施服务商累计合作建立110个前置仓，覆盖全国86个地市，进一步夯实仓储物流能力。
In addition, we continue to develop the capabilities of our car transaction services platform. In terms of customer acquisition and services, in line with our long-term plans, in the second quarter, we expanded our team of independent sales reps.An important method to generate sales leads to more than 13,000. Our sub-dealers grew to 581 as of June 30, 2021, further increasing our private traffic. Notably, we updated the web app of Kango 车生活 on WeChat in the second quarter, offering a one-stop service that covers car purchases, car usage, and car maintenance.With Kango 好车 and Kango 车生活, we empower car dealers and serve car buyers. On supply chain operations, by the end of the second quarter, we have co-developed a total of 110 warehouses together with infrastructure service providers, covering 86 cities nationwide, further enhancing our warehouse capacity.
二季度以保险促成为主的车后市场业务共计收入人民币5187万元。继续对公司营收产生重要贡献。以车险业务为抓手，从需求场景出发，灿谷为车主推荐优质丰富的保险购买渠道，涵盖车险、非车险、健康险等多元化险种。该季我们继续提升保险直销团队的能力，并新开拓500余家汽贸级维保门店渠道。在系统搭建方面，我们和保险公司促成系统对接，上线产品库小程序，未来会进一步整合服务类产品。KA 团队延续上季度步调，继续推进与多家新能源厂商的合作谈判，试点工作预计于三季度逐步落地。
In Q2, revenues from aftermarket services facilitation were 51.9 million RMB, making a sizable contribution to the company's total revenues.Focusing on car insurance business and starting from the demand side, we recommended high-quality insurance purchase channels to car owners, covering a wide range of insurance products, including car insurance, non-car insurance, and health insurance. We continue to develop our direct sales team and establish partnerships with more than 500 auto trade and maintenance operators. In the meantime, we continue to integrate our systems with those of insurance companies and launch the WeChat mini program for product library.Going forward, we will further integrate more aftermarket services, Additionally, our K18 continued partnership negotiations with several new energy vehicle makers. Pilots are expected to roll out in the third quarter.
最后，作为我们主要业务板块的汽车助贷业务，在二季度发展稳健。第二季度，公司完成新增汽车贷款额人民币77.9亿元，同比上涨57.5%。汽车助贷业务收入人民币3.03亿元，同比上涨111%，为去年同期为1.44亿元。截至二季度，再贷余额累计达人民币486.38亿元。
Finally, automotive financing facilitation, our main business line, also grew steadily in the second quarter. We facilitated new financing transactions for cars amounting to 7.79 billion RMB, up 57.5% year-on-year. Our automotive financing facilitation revenues were 303 million RMB, up 111% from 144 million RMB in the same period of last year. As of June 30, 2021, total outstanding balance of financing transactions facilitated by the company amounted to 48.64 billion RMB.
资产质量方面，受公司存量产品结构变化的影响，截至2021年6月30日，公司所有已完成并在存续期的汽车贷款的 M1 加以及 M3 加预期率分别为 1.35% 和 0.69%， 较上季度略有上升。针对预期率上升的问题，我们将进一步强化自主风控能力建设，提高风险识别和应对能力。我们对公司整体资产质量保持信心。
Now turning to asset quality, as of June 30, 2021, due to changes in our stock product mix, the M1 plus and M3 plus overdue ratio rose slightly to 1.35% and 0.69% respectively. Going forward, we plan to continue strengthening our risk management system and improve our risk identification and control capabilities. We remain confident in our overall asset quality.
渠道方面，截至二季度末，灿谷合作的汽车经销商总数达到47,740家，渠道结构进一步优化，客群进一步上千。值得一提的是，即使受到缺芯的大环境影响，我们在高端品牌渠道中的市占率稳中有微升。截至到六月底，合作的 4S 经销商9,300余家，其中包括豪华品牌，包括 BBA 和雷克萨斯经销商近500家。
In terms of dealership network, we had 47,740 registered dealers as of June 30, 2021. Our channel mix and customer base have been further improved. Notably, despite the impact of the global chip shortage, our share in the high-end market segment has risen. As of June 30, 2021, we have covered more than 9,300 forex dealers, including about 500 luxury brand dealers, such as major German luxury brands, including BMW, Mercedes, and Audi, and also Lexus.
随着消费者对新能源汽车的接受程度逐年提高，新能源汽车在中国的渗透率有望进一步提升。同时，应对全球气候变化的挑战，中国也做出了力争2030年前二氧化碳排放达到峰值，努力争取2060年前实现碳中和的承诺。发展新能源汽车是交通领域实现碳减排目标的重要措施。我们一直以来非常看好新能源汽车行业，凭借灿谷的业务模式与新能源汽车的业态高度契合，利用我们广泛的下沉经销商网络，我们将助力新能源厂商线上化和其直营模式最后一公里的实现。目前，灿谷不仅是理想汽车全国范围的服务合作伙伴，还覆盖特斯拉上海全部门店，同时与小鹏、广汽能源等厂商合作，为其提供涵盖交易、金融、保险、交付的全流程服务。
NEVs are becoming more popular, the penetration rate of NEVs in China is expected to further increase. Meanwhile, in an effort to address the global climate change crisis, China has officially announced its carbon emission peaking and neutrality goals for 2030 and 2060 respectively. the development of NEVs is key to achieving emission reduction targets in the transport sector. We have always believed in the future of NEVs, and our business model is highly consistent with that of NEV manufacturers. We are committed to supporting NEV makers to realize the last mile of their direct sale model by leveraging our extensive dealership network in the lower tier markets. At present, Kango is Li Auto's nationwide service partner and also covers all of Tesla's stores in Shanghai. We also work with XPeng, GAC, New Energy, and other NEV manufacturers on transactions, financing, insurance, and delivery services, and so on.
展望未来，今年下半年汽车行业芯片短缺以及国内金融监管环境变化等外部压力仍将持续，预计会对我们的业务造成影响。灿谷将延续既定战略路线，坚守让消费者简单愉悦购车的信念，将继续一步一个脚印地朝着消费者首选的购车服务平台的目标前行。
Looking ahead, we expect a global chip supply shortage in the auto industry and impact from domestic financial regulatory changes to continue in the second half of 2021, which may create challenges for our business. But we will continue to execute our strategies and uphold our commitment to facilitating easy and enjoyable car purchase experiences. We remain dedicated to our goal of building an auto service platform of choice for consumers.
接下来有请我们的首席财务官张永毅来回顾一下公司在本季度的财务表现。
Next, I will turn over to our CFO Michael Zhang to review our financial performance in more details.
Thanks, Xiaoyuan, and hello everyone, and welcome to our second quarter 2021 earnings call. Before I start to review our financials, please note that unless otherwise stated, all numbers are in RMB terms and all percentage comparisons are on a year-over-year basis. Our second quarter financial performance was in line with our expectations. Total revenues came in at 946.7 million, more than tripling from a year ago. Revenue from car trading transactions were 522.5 million, continuing to serve as an important revenue contributor. Revenue from automotive financing facilitation and off-market services facilitation was 303.3 million and 51.9 million, respectively. While uncertainties stemming from global chip supply chain disruption are ongoing, we remain committed to improving our operating efficiency while continually investing in business to deliver more value to our dealers, partners, and users. Now let's move on to our costs and expenses during the quarter. Total operating costs and expenses in the second quarter of 2021 were 933.5 million, compared to 207.4 million in the same period of 2020. This was mainly due to the related costs incurred by car trading transaction business, primarily as a result of the increase in revenue from car trading transactions, sales and marketing expenses, general and administrative expenses, and research and development expenses, each decreased as a percentage of total revenue in the second quarter of 2021 compared to the same period of 2020. Cost of revenue in the second quarter of 2021 increased to 697.8 million from 102.8 million in the same period 2020. As a percentage of total revenue, cost of revenue in the second quarter of 2021 was 73.7% compared to 37.5% in the same period 2020, and the change was primarily due to an increase in the amount of car trading transactions. For automotive financing facilitation and off-market services facilitation, cost of revenue as a percentage of relevant revenues was around 41.6% in the second quarter of 2021. Sales and marketing expenses in the second quarter of 2021 were 60.9 million compared to 42.4 million in the same period 2020. As a percentage of total revenue, sales and marketing expenses in the second quarter of 2021 was 6.4% compared to 15.5% in the same period 2020. General and administrative expenses in the second quarter of 2021 were 64.7 million compared to 66 million in the same period 2020. As a percentage of total revenue, general and administrative expenses in the second quarter 2021 was 6.8% compared to 24.1% in the same period 2020. Research and development expenses in the second quarter 2021 were 15.6 million compared to 12.9 million in the same period 2020. As a percentage of total revenues, research and development expenses in the second quarter 2021 was 1.7% compared to 4.7% in the same period 2020. Net loss on risk assurance liability in the second quarter 2021 was 35.9 million compared to a net gain of 42.9 million in the same period 2020. Net loss on risk assurance liability in the second quarter of 2021 was mainly due to an uptick in delinquent loan balance and default rate since the beginning of 2021. We recorded income from operations of 13.2 million in the second quarter of 2021 compared to 66.7 million in the same period of 2020. Due to the fair value change of the company investments in Li Auto, net income in the second quarter of 2021 was 557.7 million. Non-GAAP adjusted net income in the second quarter of 2021 was 578.3 million. On a per share basis, diluted net income per ADS in the second quarter of 2021 was 3.75, and diluted non-GAAP adjusted net income per ADS in the same period was 3.89. Moving on to our balance sheet, as of June 30, 2021, we had cash and cash equivalents of 1.5 billion compared to 1.6 billion as of March 31st, 2021. As of June 30th, 2021, the company had short-term investments of 3.1 billion compared to 2.6 billion as of March 31st, 2021. Looking ahead to the third quarter of 2021, we expect our total revenue to be between 700 million and 750 million. Please note that this forecast reflects our current and preliminary view on the market and operational conditions, which are subject to change. This concludes our prepared remarks. Operator, we are now ready to take questions. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. We will now begin the question and answer session. To ask a question, you may press star, then one on your touchtone phone. If you're using a speakerphone, please pick up the handset before pressing the keys. If at any time a question has been addressed and you'd like to withdraw your question, please press star, then two. Again, it is star, then one to ask a question. At this time, we will pause momentarily to assemble our roster. And the first question we have will come from Shelley Wang of Morgan Stanley. Please go ahead.
管理层好，我是摩根斯丹利的 Shelly。我有三个问题想请教一下。一个是关于我们三季度的 guidance， 就是7到 7.5 亿的这个 revenue guidance 的话，我们车交易业务大概会占比多少？然后这个是多少是因为受那个汽车缺芯影响？受到缺芯的影响。第二个的话是想请教一下，就是我们车交易这边的那个毛利率，就是。一样的，就是如果车源紧张的话，我们有没有看到毛利率在提升的这个迹象？第三个的话是关于拨备这些，就是我们看到今年的一季度、二季度都有一些就是 risk assurance liability 啊，然后有一些 provision。那这个的话，就是在未来几个季度的这个趋势大概会怎么样？这三个问题，谢谢。
Hi, I'm Shelley from Morgan Stanley. I have three questions. The first question is about your guidance for revenue in Q3, 700 to 750 million. How much of that is from car trading transaction business? And could you comment on the impact of the chip shortage on these numbers? And the second question is about the gross margin for car trading transactions. Did gross margin increase thanks to the or due to the car supply? Car supply shortage. And the third question is about some metrics of provision. That is, in Q1 and Q3, I noticed these metrics of risk sharing liabilities and also provisions. So could you comment on the trends of these two metrics in the future?
谢谢这个问题，请我们 CFO 永毅回答一下。
I will ask Michael Zhang, our CFO, to address your questions.
谢谢 Sherry 的问题，那我先回答一下第一个问题，就是在三季度的 guidance 当中的这个整个来源于汽车交易的收入的话，预计会占到55%左右，也就是说它的占比跟二季度基本持平，那么绝对数字的话呢？ 预计是在差不多4亿左右的这样的一个 revenue，就第二个问题的话，就是在这个整个车交易的这样的一个，您可能第二个小问题吧，就第一个问题，第二小，就是说对应于整个的一个 guidance 的这样的一个影响因素嘛。 那这个当中的话呢，其实我们理解可能主要是两个方面吧，一个是供给侧，那供给侧的话呢，实际上主要就是受到芯片的这样的一个影响，那么这个当中呢，对我们的整个车交易的影响会是更加的这个显著，因为从三季度的这样状态情况看，实际上车源的这样的一个影响，对于我们整个车交易的一个整个业务量的影响，应该是一个非常重要重大的这样的一个因素吧。 那么这个是我想是一个方面，同时的话呢，因为这个供应链就车源的这样的一个紧缺，导致说因为从车源的整个供应链是先由这个核心城市的 4S 店，然后再下沉到这个下沉市场的这个二级网络店吧，那么在这个过程中的话呢，实际上对于整个供应链的影响，对于下沉市场的这个影响应该会更大一些。那么上半年的话呢，主要是有一个库存的这样的一个 去化的这样的一个支撑吧，所以呢，总的一个业务量应该说还可以达到，还可以处在一个相对不错的这么一个状态。但是呢，进入三季度的话呢，我们理解这个看到这个整个车源的这个紧张的这样的一个供应吧，对下沉市场影响会更加的显著。那么我们讲这个是供给侧的这个影响。另外的话呢，实际上从需求侧，因为我们也看关注到在整个的一个下沉市场的 整体的这个需求，实际上进入到二季度以后，从整个新车的需求情况来看的话，显著的还是比较疲弱的。所以这块的话呢，实际上不仅是影响到我们的整个小B端的这个交易的一个业务量，同时的话呢，对我们整个的一个车金融的这个业务，应该会有一个非常直接的一个影响，好吧？这个是我对第一个问题的回答。那我先停一下。
Thank you, Shelley, for your questions. Let me take your first question first. Well, about our revenue guidance for Q3, in terms of contribution from car trading transactions to our Q3 revenue, we expect it to be at about 55%. So basically in line with the development in Q2. In terms of absolute number for revenue guidance, we expect the car trading transactions contribute about 400 million to the total revenue. And the second part of your first question, that is the factors impacting on our guidance for car trading transactions. Well, I would like to answer this question from two perspectives. Firstly, on supply side. Actually, the chip supply shortage does have a big impact on our car trading transactions. And in Q3, we expect the shortage of car supply to have quite a big impact. And also, we expect the car supply shortage to gradually cascade down from the forest stores in tier 1, tier 2 cities to non-forest stores in the lower tier cities. So in fact, we expect a bigger impact on the lower tier markets. In the first half, thanks to, historic stock of cars, we still have enjoyed quite a strong business growth in the first half. However, in Q3, we expect the car supply shortage to continue and the impact will be more significant than in the first half of this year. And secondly, on the demand side, well, actually in Q2, in the lower tier cities, the demand for new cars have been quite weak. So this had quite a big impact on our small dealers partners as well as on our car financing transactions.
您问的这个第二个问题就是关于整个车交易的毛利率，整个车交易的毛利率呢，更多的是受到这个车型的影响，也就是说总体看，相对更畅销的车型，它的毛利率相对是比较低的，因为这个是来源于整个 OEM 的这个定价的这样的一个因素吧，本身它在这个价格端，给到终端的这个空间就是比较小，所以因为它是一个畅销车型嘛。那么对于相对不是那么畅销的这样的一些车型的话呢，它的毛利率会更高一些，所以呢，这个呢可能总体上来讲跟芯片的这样的一个因素啊，我们理解可能影响不是特别的显著，那么这是第一点。那么第二点的话呢，就是基于我们自身吧，因为我们从整个车交易的这个布局来讲，这个作为我们的一个新的战略性业务，所以我们在起点的这个过程中的话呢，我们会更多的从一个风险管控和这个运营效率的角度，会更多的采购一些更加畅销的这样的车型，以保障我们在一个比较短的时间内可以去进行相应的这个销售去化。同时的话呢，为了激发我们整个小 B 端的这样的一个交易能力，那么我们在整个的一个B 的交易中，也给到小 B 留出了一个比较有吸引力的这样的一个毛利空间吧。所以呢，实质上我们在确定我自身的这个毛利的这样的一个定价的一个结构中呢，我们总体的策略是采取一个就是相对稳定的这样的一个策略，也就是说一个是保障更快的这个消化这个我们的整个车源的这样的一个存货，同时的话呢也是为了给到我们的小 B 留到足够有吸引力的这样的一个毛利空间，以激发他们的这个交易能力。所以呢，总体来讲，我们的在整个车交易的这个象限内，我们的整个一个交易的毛利应该是处在一个比较稳定的这么一个状态。那我请。
And to answer your second question on the gross margin of car trading transaction business. Well, actually the main factor impacting on the gross margin is the car models. That is for popular car models, usually the gross margin for us is lower because OEMs when they price these popular car models, they usually don't give a lot of room for negotiation. And for unpopular car models, however, the gross margins could be higher. And so in terms of the factors impacting on gross margin of our car transaction business, really it's not about the chip shortage. It's in fact more about the car models. And the second point I'd like to make is that on Cango's side, well, car trading transaction business is a new strategic business line for us, and it is still developing. So in order to encourage the development of this new business, and in order to better control risks and improve operational efficiency, we focus on the popular car models so that in the short term we could drive up the sales and also the growth of this business line. In addition, we are offering the smaller dealers attractive gross margins in order to help them drive up sales on their side as well. So in terms of gross margin as a whole, for us, when we consider pricing, we maintain a stable and robust pricing strategy with two purposes, as I described. That is to, first of all, ensure that the current stock of cars will, quickly be sold off. And secondly, to ensure that the small dealers have attractive enough gross margin to stimulate their business growth. So overall speaking, on the gross margin of a car trading transaction business line is steady.
您问的这个第三个问题是关于整个的一个我们的 risk assurance， 就是我们的一个拨备和我们的一个一个坏账的一个计提的逾期坏账的一个计提的这么一个问题。这一块的话呢，主要的一个点呢，是因为我们在去年的四季度吧，我们基于一个整个的一个业务模式的一个创新的这么一个考量，对于部分的这个产品的这个流程和整个的一个用户体验进行了相应的迭代。那么在这个过程中的话呢，我们也关注到对于我们的这个风控的这个整个资产的一个贷后逾期的表现，实际上是产生了一个比较负面的这样的一个影响。那么这个影响的话呢，因为我们在四季度，去年四季度发现了这样的一个状态之后，其实出现了这个状态之后，实际上我们在今年的一季度已经进行了相应的一个策略的调整。但是呢，目前看的话呢，这样的一个这个因为是一个存量资产的一个逐步的一个效果一个影响的体现嘛，所以呢，我们预计的话应该还会延续到这个今年的三季度。那么我们预计的话，应该到三季度末吧。整个的这一波的这个我们讲整个的资产逾期的这样的一个表现的话，应该会得到一个改善。
And on your third question about risk assurance liabilities as well as the provisions, well, what I would like to emphasize is that actually in Q4 last year, in order to facilitate innovation of our business models, we changed and upgraded our procedures and processes for some of our products as well as the user experience. Such measures and such strategies did have a negative impact on the overdue ratios of our assets. However, since then, actually since Q1 this year, we have also made strategic adjustments. We expect that negative impact on the stock assets to continue into Q3 this year. However, by the end of Q3, we expect the overdue ratios to improve.
谢谢。
Thank you for your questions.
非常清楚，谢谢，感谢。
The next question will come from David Pan of Goldman Sachs.
能听到吗？
可以。
首先那个还是非常恭喜公司，这个在整个行业还是有比较有挑战的，这个二季度在主要的一些战略的这个举措上，应该说都取得了非常亮眼的这个成绩和进展。我有两个问题，第一个是比较具体的一个问题，就是我看到我们二季度同比在这个助贷业务上其实是有一个比较大的，基本超过翻倍的这样的一个增长，就是收入啊。然后在后市场这边好像跟去年同期基本上是一个持平，想进一步的了解一下，就这里边的一些原因，是我们的保险相关的业务或者其他的有没有什么最近的一些趋势或者因素。然后第二个问题是关于新能源车，那个刚才管理层也做了比较具体的分享，包括我们跟理想、跟小鹏、跟特斯拉等在这个最新的一些推进的一些情况。我想进一步了解一下，就是我们帮他提供的具体的服务，以及这些服务如何对应到我们的这个财务表现，包括收入上面，在我们那个交易啊、这个助贷和后市场这些不同的板块下面，以及这些在咱们三季度和下半年的一个展望的趋势。谢谢。
Thank you. First of all, congratulations on the management, to the management on your strong performance and also strong progress in Q2 despite the challenges in the overall market. So I have three questions mainly. The first question is about the business performance of the auto loan facilitation business and also the aftermarket business. Well, in the second half, in Q2, I noticed that the revenue from the auto loan facilitation business almost doubled, and the revenue from the aftermarket services remained flat. So could you give us more colors on the reasons for such a performance, and also could you share with us your outlook for future trends and also the factors that will impact on the revenue performance in the future? And second question is about NEVs. In your presentation, you talked about your partnerships with Li Auto, Tesla, and also XPeng and other NEV makers. So could you share with us more information on the type of services that you offer to these NEV makers, and also how do these partnerships on these services contribute to your financial performance, for example, to revenue growth? And could you share with us, you know, the specific impact on your car trading business line and auto loan facilitation business line, as well as the aftermarket service business line respectively? And also the third question is about your outlook for Q3 and the second half as a whole.
好，David，回答一下你的问题，就是关于后期保险业务。保险业务在那个中国保险车险费改之后，它的业务模式产生了很大的变化，然后整个价格，整个我们整个的业务模式，包括各地保险公司的联络上，就是都面临着一个新课题。所以呢，我们这方面的那个保险的业务的增长啊，没有预期的那么快。所以这是回答你第一个问题，然后跟那个理想能源新合作呢，我们主要是在一个是我们所有的那个金融系统是嵌入理想的销售 APP 的，所以他的客户在线上下定的同时都能直接跟我们的金融产品直接连通。同时，他的车险也是，他的车险是由我们的那个保险部门，为他同各个保险公司、各地的保险车险公司进行联络，然后安排好所有的具体操作。然后他的客户也是在他的销售 APP 上也可以获得一键式服务。
Okay, so I will take your first two questions. The first question about the insurance, that is the aftermarket services business line. Well, because of fee liberalization reform in the China market, the business models of insurance companies saw big changes over the business models of insurance companies have since seen big changes. For us, you know, how to meet the new challenges and how to better partner with insurance companies and adapt to the new business models, these have been the issues for us to address. So that's why, you know, why our insurance business hasn't been growing as we expected to be. And the second question, our partnership with NEV makers, including Li Auto. Well, for Li Auto specifically, for our car financing transaction business, our system for this business is in fact directly integrated into the sales app of Li Auto. So, for example, when a customer of a Li Auto makes an order offline, the information is directly fed into our system, and then we can provide the necessary services to the Li Auto customer service. And the same principle applies to the car insurance business. For example, we help liaison and connect with the insurance car insurance companies, and then we feed the information into the auto insurance business system, and then the customer service employees of the auto then will see the information on their sales app. So we offer one-stop car insurance services as well.
在那个跟XPeng的合作中呢，跟理想的合作模式略有不同。我们跟XPeng的合作是，类似于从我们的系统中收集那个客户采购XPeng的订单，然后集中起来向那个XPeng下，采购，然后在这个过程中来提供我们所有的能提供的金融服务和保险服务。
However, our partnership model with XPeng is different from that with Li Auto. With XPeng, first of all, on our side, we collect customer orders and relevant information in our system, and then we bulk purchase the cars from XPeng. So in the process, we also provide, you know, financing products as well as insurance products to the customers.
回答完了，戴维。
I think that's all from my side.
好的，谢谢林总。
谢谢。
Again, as a reminder, if you'd like to ask a question, please press star then one on a touch-tone phone. Again, that is star then one to ask a question. Again, we will just pause momentarily to assemble our roster. Again, that is star then one to ask a question. Okay, we have no further questions at this time. I will hand the conference call back over to management for any closing remarks.
Okay, thanks. 没有了。
Thank you, everybody. That closes today's earnings call.
We thank you, ma'am, and to the rest of the management team for your time also today. Again, the conference call is now concluded. At this time, you may disconnect your lines. Thank you, everyone. Take care and have a great day.